Father, it's Friday today. I just got back from my wonderful, wonderful trip to Thailand yesterday early morning, basically. It was a solo trip and I took vlogging very, very seriously and I had a really good time. In case you missed it, I visited Chiang Rai, which is a city in the north of Thailand, and I also visited Bangkok, which is their capital city, which is pretty much in the center or more towards the south. Anyway, so today I am going on yet another trip. This is not an international trip though. This is super short, just for work, but I thought it would be fun nonetheless, and I thought I would vlog and bring you guys along just because it's something different. I am heading to Delhi today for Pop Exo BFF, or Big Fab Fest. It's happening tomorrow, but since there are going to be like rehearsals and stuff for the runway show very early in the morning, they've called us the previous evening itself, so that'll be good, so that I can just settle into my room there in Delhi and just mentally prepare for BFF. So I'm not really feeling my best because I think my luggage from Thailand was a little too much. I overdid the shopping, obviously, and then, like, you know, just carrying my handbags, I felt really tired. And since then, last night after coming back, I felt a bit feverish. I don't think it's anything serious, it's just kind of a little bit of exhaustion, but I am taking a tablet for it and I think I'll be okay. Yeah, I wish I was feeling 100%, but we're gonna make this work and we're gonna make this fun nonetheless. Not going to complain about it, hopefully. Before I leave though, I have to go to the airport right now. I want to show you what's in this little yellow box in front of me, yellow basket. I also just got my Coves order. It's a giant box behind me. Don't worry, it's not such a big order, it's just bulky stuff, but I don't have time to open that, but I want to show you what's in the box, so I'll do that. This is a new little kitten we are fostering from World for All. It's really bad timing for us because I'm busy and my mom's going to have to handle him. We didn't want to foster as such, it was like, but he really needed a home. Like, he needed a home last night, or they didn't know what they were going to do with him. So that's why we took him in. Mom said that she could manage because I'm not going to be there now for 2 days. And he's absolutely adorable. Honestly, without a doubt, he is the cutest kitten we've ever had. And his name is Tarzan, but he's also called Jinga. Guys, check him out. He's adorable. He's so cute. You would have seen him on my Instagram stories also. He's maybe about 3 weeks old. My own cats sort of hate me right now and they hate all of us. But they're going to have to learn to share for a little while and they're going to have to adjust. We are not adopting him. We are just fostering him temporarily until he can be a little bit bigger, a little more stable and find a good home. He's so active. He's so cute. He's just a darling. We love him. So I wanted to show him to you guys. I got him last night. He doesn't want to be in the basket, but we do have to keep him there because of the other cats for now. But we give him a lot of time outside and he loves sleeping on our body. Isn't he cute? So I'm finally on my way and I decided to wear this new sweatshirt that I bought from H&M. As you can see, it's got sushi on it. I think this type of sushi is called sashimi, if I'm not mistaken, because I end up eating rolls most of the time. Sushi rolls are called maki rolls. So maki means roll, basically, as far as I know. I'm no expert, but I'm still learning a little bit as I go. So Debashree picked up the t-shirt version of this sweatshirt, which I think is from the summer collection, like the bygone collection. And she sent me a picture on WhatsApp saying, go to H&M, buy this and let's start twinning. But I couldn't find it anywhere. I was sad until I found the sweatshirt version of it. I was like, okay, I can wear this for winter time. It's just so much fun. It makes me very happy. And I just bought it a size up so that it can be really cozy. I don't like my sweatshirts to stick anyway. I really like those nice, roomy, oversized ones. When you take a trip this soon after taking another trip, then packing is basically just picking up stuff from one suitcase or one bag and putting it in another one. So that is how I pack today. Don't be like me, guys. Don't pack so late. Try to pack early so that you don't worry so much. I mentioned that I'm traveling to Delhi for a PopExo event. I am a member of the PopExo blog network. I am a super blogger, actually, their blog network. So I'm traveling with a bunch of other super bloggers from Mumbai, and I think some of them are like coming down from Pune or something, but we are all on the same flight. Some of them I know quite well. I bump into all the time. But a few of them I'm going to be meeting for the first time. I've never met face to face before, so that should be fun. And I'll also be meeting the Delhi super bloggers, and best of all, I think I'll be meeting some of you guys. I did announce on my Instagram that I'm coming to Delhi, so I'm really looking forward to all of it. I checked in, got through security, and I'm already here waiting at my boarding gate. My flight boards in 1.5 hours. I know that's a really long time, but I'm always very early because I don't want to miss flights. And even though I live pretty damn close to both of the airports in Mumbai, you can't predict the traffic, especially this time. So I'd rather be early. And my flight app though is telling me that the flight has been delayed further by 1 hour, but the airport or the airline haven't announced it yet. My flight app's rarely wrong though, so I'm guessing it'll be announced in some time. Let's see. But I've got my soft drink, I've got my favorite chicken popcorn, and I have my phone, earphones, and a portable battery that's going to last forever. So if I have to wait, I have to wait. Hi guys, we are in Delhi. It's after midnight. We should have been here by 10. It's after midnight. We're exhausted. I think I can speak for everyone in that sense. So yeah, we are in two cars right now. Here is Shivani and Juhi, and Ashna is in the front seat. I'll make you meet everybody when we're all just a little better rested in the morning. I finally stepped into my room. All of us did, in fact. We just waited till everyone got a room. And it is 1:10 right now. 1:10, guys. I can't believe PopExo BFF is today, and I'm up here at 1:10. That kind of sucks, to be honest. Anyway, happy that I finally got the room. We're staying at Lemon Tree Residency or something. The room seems fair. I'll give you guys a quick room tour, but we definitely didn't like the check-in experience. It was really sucky. It was very slow. And even though check-in times are 2 p.m. and we are like so much later, so much, we are like 10, 11 hours later, they took a long time and it was just not a good experience. So I'm already telling you guys, don't come to Lemon Tree. That being said, I'm going to order some room service now because I wanted to come quickly before I grab some sleep, some shut-eye. I'm not even making sense. I also need to take a shower because I have to wash my hair and stuff. So that's what's up. Service order, so I'm feeling better already. You've seen around the room, it's pretty good. It also has a bathtub. I probably won't soak right now, but maybe I can do it later today after PopExo BFF. I'll probably be tired, so I hope the food is good. Until then, I'm just gonna get ready for a shower. I don't know whether I can like quickly do it before the food comes, but because it's going to be embarrassing if I'm showering and the food comes and I have to come out in a robe, that'd be weird. So I'm not sure what to do, but I think I may try to go quickly, because if their room service time is anything like their check-in time, it is going to take forever. So I decided to have my quick shower before the food came, which was a good decision. I finished my shower, got into my clothes properly, and now the food has arrived. Here is my room service. I'll show you guys what I got. First up is fish and chips with tartar sauce. Then I have a rasmalai and a fresh pineapple juice. This looks like a good meal. I want to eat it as fast as I can and then go to sleep. Morning guys, so it's around 8:20 in the morning and I'm all dressed up because it's time to leave really soon. So now I haven't heard from any of the other girls this morning yet. We'll all be traveling together, so I'm just waiting to hear from them, and I would like nothing more than to sleep right now. But duty calls, and it's going to be a long fun day. Kind of having an internal debate about whether or not to put any makeup on, because we're gonna have makeup artists do our makeup at the venue, but I think I'll do something really basic because I'm sitting idle right now anyway. Way to the venue, which is Killa. It's like Killa means fort, but this is a very hipster way of writing Killa. And I have Shivani and Kavya.
Good morning.
We are too sleepy to be all into like her.
This is why I put on sunglasses, guys. Like, really, I just put them on like before I opened up my camera. So Kavya and I were in Thailand at the same time, and we were very close by in a sense. I was in Chiang Rai, she was in Chiang Mai.
Yeah, but we still were away. And we did totally different things, right? Like we.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
So it was like close but not close. And today we are both on a panel talking about how to get your perfect selfie with Oppo. So that'll be fun.
I hope so.
Now we're on our way to the venue, obviously. I think I already mentioned that. And looking forward to fittings, makeup, briefings and all that. Rehearsals are done. We did a rehearsal like 2-3 times. It went really smoothly. They're playing really cool 80s music during our walk, so I like that. If you're wondering why I look like this in bright sunlight, it's because of the roof cloth thing happening that is making me look very pink orange or whatever. So right now I'm just sitting on the ground in the makeup cum changing room, which is basically like a tent, but at least it's air conditioned, so that's nice. And a lot of girls are here with me. I'm gonna make you say hi to them finally. Here's Kavya and Juhi, Stephanie and Shivani. Now we're really, really thirsty and a little bit hungry, so we're trying to figure out what to do. Makeup and hair is done, and you can get an idea of what it's like.
Yes,
no. Enormous excitement.
Guys,
up directly. Or everyone else was already changed, so we just had to quickly do it and just stash our stuff somewhere. Work went pretty well for all of us. I was nervous. It probably showed on my face. But if I get some footage, I'm going to put it here so you guys can see the walk. It was a lot of fun. Everything said and done. I was nervous, but it was so much fun. And nice experience to have. The crowd was very, very warm to us. And yeah, it was fun. I'm going to say that again. So I didn't vlog while I was in my outfit. So I'm going to try to put some video or photos so you can see. The outfit and makeup was something very different than what I would usually go for. And I feel like that was definitely part of the fun and part of the reason why I enjoyed it. Because where's the fun if you don't step out of your comfort zone? I love this graphic sort of eyeshadow that they've done. It is super cool. The hair and makeup team did an amazing job, as did the choreographers. So, yes. Now we're very tired, though we have like this burst of energy after the walk, waiting to get back to our rooms. Okay, so back in the hotel room, and it's time for a little chatty post-walk sum up. It went really nicely, I think, in the end. Of course, I can find some flaws with my walk. And I looked down and I looked awkward on my face. Yeah, it seemed obvious to me. But at the end of the day, I think it went really well. And I enjoyed the experience. It was a goodie bag, a small little one. So I thought I would just open it up with you guys. I haven't really looked inside. I think I snuck a tiny, tiny peek. But that's about it. So let's see what's in here. One at a time. First thing is, what is this? 4700 BC gourmet popcorn. I have tried this brand earlier. It was not bad. I didn't like it too much, to be honest. It was not bad though. Now it says a PVR product, so I don't know if PVR bought it. Nice tin though, really nice tin. So I will try this out soon and report maybe in a vlog. Next thing, I don't know what this is. What is this? Oh, something from Dorothy Perkins. So Jabong, nice. I think it's like a sort of a clutch. Let me just open it. Yeah, it is an envelope clutch in this perfect camel hue, which I think is great for fall and very similar to the top I was wearing today. I think it was also from Dorothy Perkins, if I'm not mistaken. It feels like suede, but I don't think it's real suede. I think it would be like suedette. So it's also vegan then if you don't use leather or suede. It's a nice size. And yes, it has a zip and it's cool. It's not going to fit my vlogging camera because it's fattish, but it'll fit like phone, lipstick, money, all that stuff. The next thing is this little, oh, so cute. It's like an Indian sari wearing version of the Oppo mascot. I really like their cute mascot anyway, but this Indianized version is just too adorable. Oh, it must be like something special for Diwali. I like it. I think she's holding a diya as well. How cute is this? I think my dad's really going to like this. He's sometimes a bigger kid than me, like he still likes Happy Meal toys. And final thing in here, no, not the final thing. Ooh, this is Sugar Threads cotton candy. Cotton candy in a dabba, oh my god. And there's like glitter also, but I think it's edible. It'll be edible, yeah. It's so cute. This is so nicely packed, so I'm gonna take it home and share it with the fam. And what else is in here? I think this would be a pen from Oppo. Kind of feels like the general pen shape, right? Let me see. Guys, it says selfie stick, really cool. I'm just a little tired, so I'm not going to open it right now because it's sealed. But it says selfie stick over here. And I think there's something else in here, like a thank you letter or something. Oh, from My Glam, Magali Vaz. My name's even here. It's spelled right the first time and it's spelled wrong the second time. Why? So I'm guessing this is a voucher to try out the My Glam app. says I can try out the Forest Essentials facial complimentary. And the whole USP of My Glam is that they come to your home and do it. So that's really cool. And it's available in Mumbai, Pune and Delhi. Nice. Is there anything else in here? There is a paper. I don't think that's anything. It is something. It's something from the Label Life. I love the Label Life. I just met their founder today because I've worked with them in the past, like not worked as an employee but done blogger stuff with them. She's very sweet. So let me open this. Ooh, 2000. It's a 2000 voucher, guys. The code's at the back, so I'm not going to show you. I really like stuff the Label Life has, right from their clothes. I like their clothes. They're very nice. I like their accessories, but I love their homewares the most. So I'm just going to have a very hard time picking out exactly what to buy, but this has made me very happy. So I'm about to step in the shower right now. I thought I'll just show you what's been a relatively new addition to my skincare, because my skin has been behaving really badly these last couple of months. Too much of acne, clogged pores, and this month has been sort of stressful. I mean the good kind of stressful, because I've been continuously traveling, but my skin is sensitive and breaks out very, very easily. And I've been trying to get it a bit under control. So I've been religiously using since the start of the month, like since the start of October, if you're unsure of which month this is, the La Roche-Posay range, specifically these three products. This is the face wash. It's a purifying foaming gel for oily sensitive skin. Just perfect for my skin type, oily and sensitive. That makes me very happy. And also then this... Wait, let me read what's this. This is the Effaclar Lotion Astringent Micro Exfoliant. So this sort of nicely, mildly exfoliates sensitive skin and also takes out any traces of makeup, grime or dirt that the face washes may have missed or your cleansers may have missed. And believe me, when I started using this, I realized that cleansing just once is not enough. You need to double cleanse or use a toner afterwards, because you do get like some grime and stuff. And finally, after that, I use this. You guys must be knowing what this is. It's the famous Effaclar Duo Plus. I've used it in the past, but never as part of the entire like rain. I've been just so religious with using this skincare at least once a day, like you would not believe. Otherwise, I'm very lazy. But I wanted to see if this will like sort of improve my skin, get it under control. And like I hope to do a review of the range really soon. So far, I'm really liking it. I'm seeing positive changes. Skin is not going to magically improve overnight. That'll never happen. But it's just acting better. It's not acting so crazy. There are less pimples, pores are less clogged and stuff. So yeah, I am pretty pleased with it for now. Here's what I got for dinner today. It's pretty like much a mixed bag. This is Indian sea bass, I think. But it's obviously a continental style dish. And there are veggies and potatoes and bread and stuff. I think that's the sauce that goes with the sea bass. This is called Italian smooch. It's basically just a mocktail with coke, lime, grenadine and ginger ale, I think. This has me super excited. This is basically fried lady's finger or okra. I don't know how to pronounce that. And it's just fried really crispy. I love it this way. And it has amchur, which is dry mango powder, so it's nice and tangy. And I already took a little nibble of this. Absolutely love it. I'm just going to munch on this and I might turn on the television. Hi guys, good morning. So today I finally got a glimpse of the beautiful view in front of me. There's a really nice road. I think they're growing some crops like beyond very neatly. So that was nice to see. I got the luxury of time this morning because my flight is at 2, so I got to sleep in very nicely. I thoroughly enjoyed that, and now I will be going down for breakfast. realized that maybe we were a little too chilled out. I don't know. But I just came and I sat in my boarding gate now. And the boarding has just opened. So I was just in time. I hope everyone else makes it in time. I was with Kavya and Stephanie. So yeah, I gotta get ready to board now. So I landed in Mumbai and now I'm about 2 minutes away from home. Super excited to be back as well and to hug the three kitties at home. What I'm holding! I think in my hand you can properly get an idea of how tiny he is. And he is so cute. He's a little sleepy right now. With this I say bye to you guys. See you in my next vlog. Say bye. Bye.